Okay, we are welcoming Dr. Amalia Androulidaki, General Director for the Restoration, Museums and Technical Works of the Greek Ministry of Culture and Sports. She was responsible for the reconstruction or anastylosis of the historical Plaka Bridge in Epirus, northern Greece, which was destroyed by flood waters in 2015. And this project got the European Nostra Award conservation from the European Heritage Awards. So congratulations on that. And I'm very happy that we can talk now about your fascinating project. Could you briefly describe the project in the beginning?
Yes, we are claiming the word restoration or anastylosis and not the word reconstruction, which is in the language of restoring, the restorers means that we use new materials. We didn't use new materials, so we're excluding the word reconstruction. This is to note something first. Well, Plaka Bridge is a single arched stone bridge built. And it was built in 1866, in the middle of the 19th century, on the river of Arachthos in Epirus, which is an area in Greece, and it has an arch span of 40 meters, and it's 20 meters the height over the water level of the river. It is considered one of the largest stone bridges in the Balkans. In the Balkans, it's now the largest, actually. There were some larger than this one, but they have collapsed. And it's very impressive. So it has been listed by the Greek Ministry of Culture as a work of art that deserves the protection of the state since many years. But on the 1st of February of 2015, which was a very difficult year for Greece, during a heavy storm that caused overflow of the river, the biggest part of the main arch and the east middle pier of the bridge collapsed. So the project scope was the anastylosis, as I said before, the restoration and the enhancement of the bridge, along with the highlighting of its tangible but also the intangible values, as well as the integration of the restored monument into the natural landscape. The integration into the social and cultural life of the community, and also the dissemination of the information we got with the international scientific community. The completion of the restoration and the anastylosis project has been identified also as a symbol of the concern of the Greek nation to overcome the painful years of the recession.
So what is the history of the whole project, and what were the most important objectives from your point of view?
Yes, as I said, that was the very first anastylosis of a stone bridge of the 19th century. The knowledge had been lost. We had nothing, we have not done anything like that before. And it's one of the rare similar projects globally. There is only another one in the Balkans that has been known to have been restored after the war, but it was much smaller, and there was a firm from Turkey that have restored it. So we were trying to make it with our own means. So the project underwent the following stages, which was the preliminary interdisciplinary study based on a detailed documentation of the monument and following the international principles of the Greek legislation. We have a very strict legislation about restoration, and the reason that it has collapsed from an external violent force, which was the storm, it was the excuse for restoring it. Even if we had lost a great precedence of its volume. So the documentation was offered by the National Technical University of Athens, with the collaboration of the Hellenic Ministry of Culture. It was also, the second stage was preliminary work on the site, providing access and supporting, because access was difficult as well, and supporting the remains of the bridge while rescuing the fallen fragments from the river. There were many fragments in the river that they had to be dragged out. And preparing underwater foundation, the foundation of the middle pier had gone, so we had to recreate it. And then formation of the riverbed and preparation of the construction site. These were very difficult and very important steps. We had raised the scaffolding and art support, conserve the remains, and we proceed with the anastylosis by using material from the original quarries of the stone, and the same materials and techniques as the original structure, because we were able to identify this. From the fallen parts, we were able to identify the original structure and the techniques. The next step was the construction of the side walls inside the riverbed, and finally removal of the arch mold and monitoring the bridge's response. Monitoring was very important, especially during the first couple of weeks, because there was slight movement. We were expecting it, but it had not to move beyond a certain limit, which was the 4 centimeters. But the movement we had was only 1.5 centimeters, so that was positive. The participants that were involved were the Ministry, of course, of Culture, but the Ministry of Infrastructure as well. It was the very first time we collaborated with them. The Ministry of Finance, who gave the money, the Prefecture of Epirus, the National Technical University of Athens, the Technical Chamber of Greece, and the local council. The budget was 5,800,000 euros, and also there was some contribution from the region of for the prefecture of Epirus, and from private funds. The anastylosis was inspired by the strong demand of the Greek people and has contributed to their morale to face challenges with success based on the cultural heritage values as well.
And why do you think you got this prestigious award? Were there special qualities or innovations involved that the jury made giving the award to you?
Yes, I have already mentioned most of them, but as we were told, the jury, I mean, one was that it was one of the very few anastyloses that they have been performed globally. It was also the successful outcome of an exceptional interdisciplinary collaboration and research, and has made quite an impact on the scientific community internationally by offering a wide range of expertise knowledge. Also, the landscape, I mean, the bridge serves as an important landmark in the Epirus natural landscape, and that was praised by the jury, how beautifully and how well it sets into the environment, with this simple single arch. Also, the locals have adopted and supported the anastylosis. The locals were very enthusiastic about the project and correlated it with their community and identity. Also, it is important that it's probably the largest single arch masonry bridge in South and Eastern Europe in the Balkans. These kind of structures are typical of the Balkans. These bridges, only in the river Arachthos, there are 55 bridges like that. In the whole of Balkans, there are thousands of bridges that they were connecting this area, where in the previous centuries, the people were actually commuting from one place to another for trade and for other activities as well. For feasts, for many other things, were commuting through those bridges, and it signifies the connection that the people of the Balkans had for many, many years. Borders came later and separated them.
And the Plaka Bridge also seems to have a great historical and symbolic meaning for Greece, if I got it right from the papers I read about it. Could you also explain this a bit? I think the most of the people who will watch this are not from Greece, and maybe you can explain why this, especially this Plaka Bridge, has such a meaning for, and also the whole reconstruction project had such a meaning also in the after the recession. What did it mean for the people?
Well, it was a request by the majority of Greek people, not just the locals. There was a nationwide poll carried out by the National Technical University, and people all over Greece, they were eager to give money for this anastylosis. We never asked because the state provided the money, but they thought it was very important to restore it. Actually, they didn't believe that we can do it with technically meaning, because that was a knowledge long forgotten, how to build it. So the anastylosis of the Plaka Bridge with this exceptional natural landscape has contributed to the reinstatement of the cultural landscape and re-established the network of mountain stone paved trails in Epirus. And as I said before, it's not just Epirus, it's all the Balkans. Now, the symbolic meaning of the bridge, which is connecting, exchange of ideas and trade, freedom of movement, and ability to create bonds, this symbolic meaning has been successfully transmitted to the nation, Greek nation, and beyond that, through the achievement of the Anastylosis project. It had the same effect that rituals. Rituals are very common in the tradition of the Greeks. We like rituals. These rituals, the effect the rituals have on communities is by reenacting the initial action and by restoring, in this case, the original structure of the bridge, connecting them with the past, showing this continuity. And that was in a way like a ritual, and they faced it like that. And there was a big ceremony when we finished, and they all participated. So yes, it had a symbolic meaning for all people in Greece.
So you almost see it as a national ritual, so to speak, the reconstruction.
It was a ritual even for the restorers, in a way, because we repeated something we have never done before, and we always had the feeling that the initial craftsmen were watching us, and that the headmaster, Bekas, was somewhere there and supporting what we were doing. So yes, it was, in a way, it was a ritual.
How accessible is the bridge today? Online and, of course, in reality as well.
Online, there are quite a few sites that you can. Yes, it is quite accessible online. In order to access it physically, you have to go up to the mountain of Epirus, and this is not very easy. But nevertheless, there are many people. Actually, from the time it has collapsed, there were more people visiting the place than before, and now there are too many people going there. People in the hotels there, the people that they have restaurants, and they are very, very happy because they are the ones that tell us that how many people go and visit the site, and it's a very impressive bridge as well, and. People want to go and cross it, which is a bit difficult. These bridges are very steep, but they do. They go there, and they also have this. You can cross it, yes. We have blocked it for a while, but now you can cross it with care, and it gives them this satisfaction of accomplishing an achievement of going across. and understanding and connecting with how difficult it was for people to commute, but still they found the means to communicate with each other and trade with each other, exchanging ideas at the same time, something which seems to be a bit more restricted in nowadays, especially in areas, in these areas. People commute again, but not maybe not not under the circumstances that they used to. Things are, I suppose, things are a bit more complicated now.
So you already mentioned that number of restaurants and so on started around, or at least in the broader vicinity of the bridge. So what is, can you tell us a bit more about the local impact around the Plaka Bridge of the anastylosis?
The project, as I said, has increased the income of the local community and has raised their morale against difficulties. Difficulties caused by the climate change and recession and all these crises that we are facing, and it has strengthened their bonds with each other and their identity. You know, it was very important for them that they can repeat this achievement. It offered reassurance about the future by repeating achievements like building this bridge, because it was an achievement in the past as well, of the past, achievements and actions that they have actually built what is modern state of Greece. What is Greece today? It has become what it is today because especially after the independence war, people start building bridges with all their ways, not just physically, but also building bridges with other nations as well.
So the local people feel to be a part of this, or this being a part of themselves, so to speak.
Well, when it collapsed, there were many people that they said on camera that they preferred that their own house would collapse instead of the bridge.
Okay.
For them, it was more important to have the bridge intact instead of their own house.
This is a very impressive point, actually. Thank you very much for that. Thank you for the whole talk we could have. I'm very impressed. I would like to see it once on my own. I mean, on pictures, obviously 40 meters span must be huge. I'm sure it's even more impressive in reality than on photographs, but even on photographs, it's quite impressive.
It is very impressive.
Also beautiful landscape. So, I thank you very much for the talk, and I hope many people will visit this and see what you have done there.
Great. Thank you too. And you are invited. You and all people, the contact details are available on the internet. You are invited to come and visit. People will be very happy to receive you and show you the hospitality that they always had, and to show you how proud they are of this achievement. So thank you very much. Thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to share it with you. We'll be right back.